10-year note yields continue to trade the range despite all the fireworks you're seeing off in stock land. And when we see gold prices moving around quite a bit, we continue to just trade this range in the 10-year note yield. And if you go back a ways, go back to August of 2019, we haven't seen a 10-year note trade above 2% or below 1.5%. It's kind of been stuck in that 50 basis points range, with the majority of that trading right where we are now, between 170 and 190, we'll call it. That's been sort of the lion's share of the trade. And despite the fact that extenuating circumstances are moving all these other markets around, bond market's kind of watching cautiously, maybe a little over cautiously at this point, because there may be something they're seeing, the bond market sees, that the other risk markets aren't seeing at this point. We saw this similar trade about a year ago, and right now it seems to me that we're seeing it again. What is out there keeping the bond market at bay and not seeing those yields push higher, given all the risk that we're seeing being thrown into the market? And I guess one of the reasons is because of demand, but also because I think that there is something out there. There is concern for the credit markets. There is concern with global growth, and there is concern in a lot of places that equities really aren't looking at right now. Equities are looking at returns and not necessarily looking at risk. So at this point, hovering around 180 in the 10-year note yield, something we've done for the last several months, obviously, that is going to continue. Until there's some kind of a catalyst moment, until some event comes through, maybe it's a central banking event, maybe it's something economically here domestically, maybe it's something in the world of politics, but whatever it is, the bond market isn't budging and it isn't following suit as to what we're seeing. The sell-off in the bond market hasn't been as extreme as the buying has been in equities. And if you look at volatility, you would expect volatility to be higher given that the bond market is not doing what you would think it would. However, because we've held this range for so long, it's very clearly defined. A trade above 2% probably brings in a wave of volatility. Likewise does a trade below 1.5%. We haven't seen those in so long, so the market feels very comfortable trading in that 50 basis point range, and likely will continue to do so for the foreseeable future. Lastly, let's talk about issuance, something we don't talk about here very often, but there is a new 20-year bond coming to the market, and you would think that would be enough to push yields higher. The expectations for a new 20-year, along with what we're seeing with 5s, 7s, 10s, and 30s, but we aren't seeing any real shift, at least not initially, in yield. So right now, there could be a great bit of demand building and still be there with a new issuance coming in the spring of this year. So that's going to be very interesting to watch. How will the new bond be accepted? How will the effect be on other yields, whether it be the 10 or the 30 year? At this point, we've only seen a nudge higher. And typically these markets, you see a knee-jerk reaction first and then things settle down. Well, maybe at this case, we're going to see things settle down first and then knee-jerk when they actually start to issue the bonds, likely in May of this year. But for now, the range is going to hold in 10-year note treasury yields ahead of this holiday weekend.